Hey guys, welcome back to episode 9 of my Let's Play of Dark Souls 3. I'm just gonna throw this out there. This episode's up late. I've been having I just recently got a new PC case and a new CPU cooler that I had to just completely take the parts out of the old one and reinstall it. I guess that made one of my graphics drivers have an issue, because every time I would load up Dark Souls 3, this is gonna sound really silly, there'd be a bunch of flickering lights. It looked like they're normally red, they would flicker like all around the screen, and then the screen itself would flicker, textures would glitch, and then it would crash my PC entirely. And I couldn't figure out how to fix it. I just updated the drivers and it fixed it, but it was already on the newest one, so I had to like downgrade and then upgrade again. A clean install wouldn't work, so anyways, in the last episode, we took care of the smoldering lake. Yeah, I don't think it's been a couple of days since I've played due to a lot of the PC issues, so let's go to, where is it, Crystal Sage, because we need to go to an area to the left of the bonfire. That's where the next area is that we are going to take on. Now, normally, after defeating the Crystal Sage, you would go this way anyway. You would just make your way up here. I chose not to do that, just to get a couple of things out of the way. So you can hear and see there's a little lizard down there, but I'd rather take care of this dude first. Come on. Oh shit, that other one saw me from that far, for real? Damn. We knock him off? Nope. I swear I heard that other one chasing me down. So, anyway. There he is. This dark sword is very strong. I think I'm gonna use a different weapon. What's the scaling on this butcher knife? It's A in strength. 165, 123, 130. Yeah, this does like very little compared to this, which rightfully so. We can use it. If you look down there, there's a fatty. We will leave her be for now. This probably wasn't smart. A lot of the times there's a lizard, it might be leading you into a trap. I should be two-handing this. Okay. What's this lizard give us? Twinkling Titanite. I'm gonna look around just a little bit more. What are the other paths we could have taken? It's looking like just that path overhead. Well, we can get the drop on her from back here. Let's hope she didn't. I wonder if I can get like a critical. Nope. Okay. Poorly timed to roll. Let's take an Estus. Oh god. Okay, she's gone. There's an item right here. Oh, I'm fat rolling. That's not good. 74? Damn. Okay, taking off the bow puts me under. We got the Herald set, which, let's see if we can find it. I'm assuming this is the set that you would get if you started off as the Herald class. We'll continue on this way. As you can see, there's stairs leading up, but it's also a bonfire. If we come this way, let's just say, I think this is a bad enemy. Hey dude. Oh shit, he has throwing knives. swing. Oh no, we are getting super greedy. Come on. Just need to hit him one more time. Come on, he's rolling. Wow, just die already. There we go. I will say, I haven't used this butcher knife in a long time. I'd like to use it. Paladin's Ashes. Okay, so we can give those to the handmaid in the Firelink Shrine. Is there another path up here? Looks like it. Doesn't look like there's anything down there. Looks like there's a few paths around here. I swear I hear something. Like footsteps. Okay, I guess there's not much over here. There is, if you remember in the catacombs. Okay. That doesn't look too safe. Well, fuck it, you gotta fight him someday. Come down here. I don't know what the hell he's doing with his, like, poise or whatever. So he has knives too, throwing knives. Looks like we stagger pretty well with this. Nope. See, he can kick on command. Oh, we got decent timing on that when he wasn't blocking. No. Let's conserve our stamina. Alright, well, he wasn't much of anything. You gonna drop anything? Spider shield. Yeah, that's not really what we want. The shield of one gives us a soul bonus, too. So I think we're gonna stick with that for a little bit. Okay, we have a shit show over here. We really don't want to hit the dogs? That's super annoying. At least this thing has some range to it. There's a lot of badness around here. There's another dog down there. Oh, shit. Alright, let's see if we can get this dog over here. Stop barking. Okay, we got him trapped toward a tree. There's another dog up there, too. There's a lot of evil up here. Can I, go this way? Okay, so that dies in one shot. Okay, we got another large soul. There's the dog. Alright, we are getting really good timing with that. Like, I was really just trying to dodge the arrows, but luckily the dog kind of got trapped. I know if I run out. Okay, so he's gonna come to me. Maybe not. Here's what I'm gonna do. I think we one hit. Yes, we do. Oh shit! Didn't even see that second dog come out of nowhere. Is there anything over here? Doesn't look like it's... Oh, that's probably the path that they want you to take to flank them. Oh well, I guess we did it the hard way. Okay. See, I'm paranoid because I don't really remember too much of this area. Oh, I remember this guy. Alright, check this out. Watch this. Yeah, do not let him hug you or else you will get very hurt. Oh, I thought I heard someone like screaming. Oh, we have all these things praying. I feel bad. Oh, an Estus shard. Sweet. I don't feel bad now. I did notice. Well, I apologize. I had a phone call. As I do remember in the last episode that my, the game sound, I think, the mix was loud. And I apologize for that. Like, it was kind of drowning out my voice. So, as you saw, when we entered here, we have entered the Cathedral of the Deep. Is there anything? Nope. This is the new area. This area is, I think, one of the weirdest ones. Mainly because of, it's all like this kind of like pseudo-religious, stuff, I guess. Like, you see all these like churches and, you know, like little figures and robes and stuff. We have a door over here. We cannot open this door. And shocker, we have a door over here that we also cannot open. This area that we're in now with all of like the, those aren't really pews, they're more of like chairs. We just got a whip. This area is just kind of like one kind of hub, big hub for this area. As we continue, we are going to open up a bunch of doors that, you know, lead back to this area, like shortcuts. So we're going to make our way back up here again. I guess this isn't that bad of a weapon. What am I saying? I know it's not bad. What the hell? I keep forgetting you don't have a shield, so I'm like blocking with the knife. Okay, so we can drop down here. I don't think we're going to do that yet. Up here we have, I wouldn't say a gimmick, but this whole area, these guys will not stop spawning. They're all super weak, kind of grunt enemies. Like, they grab you. They don't really do too much. It can get tough if you get circled, like, swarmed by them. Wow, we could have just went up here anyway. Excuse me. Astro Greatsword. If I'm not mistaken, if I can get to a safe spot, I'll check that out. You're alive? Damn. Jump down here. This looks decently safe. Okay, it's not. Anyway, I was wrong about that sword. There's another sword that goes under a similar name. I don't think it's a great sword, though. I think it's like a Sunlight Straight Sword, maybe? Alright. This area is rough. As you can see, a ton of these things spawn. So let's just leave that alone. Holy shit. Luckily, this butcher knife has a really wide range on it. Let's go this way. I wonder how many souls these give per kill. 26, yeah, this is not a good soul farm. Okay, so we're at the end of this graveyard, sort of. Okay. I didn't want to do, like, some fancy backstab attack. I want to kind of clear a way to run away. Because of this dude right here. No. Okay, I thought he was surviving with a little bit of health. Let's continue up this way. I don't know if you can see, but over here in the corner there's some badness. Him. Seem to be staggering pretty well. Oh god, I shit, that got super greedy. Oh my hell. Well, that was dumb. Oh no. Okay, we cannot let This area, I think its gimmick is bleed. Bleed is one of the things that I'm worst at keeping an eye on. Okay, so we are over here, right after, this is post-production, by the way. I can't believe I forgot this. This was after we killed that dual-wielding guy. If we come down here, we missed all of this stuff. Just completely ignored it. I apologize. So we're gonna grab it now. We get another large soul. Holy fuck. Young white branch. This is just like the graveyard in the Undead Settlement. If we look, hopefully off in the distance, we might be able to see it. Oh shit, it went for me. He's essentially that same giant that's like lobbing all sorts of stuff at us. So, but the main reason for that is another undead bone shard. I can quickly look around here. Doesn't look like there's much else. There, I guess there is an item right over here we forgot. But another large soul. So just throwing that in there. Figure that's really important because it's an undead bone shard. So back to the video. Essentially, once it builds up, you take, this is at least my interpretation of it, when it builds up, you take a significant chunk of damage. Curse Ward Great Shield, I'm not going to be using a Great Shield, but once it builds up, it will do a large amount of damage. This looks like, I guess it's not a lie, it will do a great amount, like one significant chunk of damage it'll do, but I believe it keeps building up. You just keep taking damage or whatever again. Something similar. Something sort of like that, at least. But it's very dangerous if it gets built up, because I don't know if I have anything to get rid of it. Okay. I knew I heard something. Holy hell. That thing, Jesus. As I was saying, I don't think we really have much to defend against it or protect against it, so we just kinda, yeah, see, that one ledge that we were at in the beginning would have dropped us down here, and then we would have had to fight our way. Actually, I guess it would have been a shorter shortcut. How many of these things are there? Three. Here's what we're gonna do. We will check that item out in a second. Okay, yeah, see, now we're massing a build-up. So I think that's, do I have anything against it? I don't think I do. Dark damage? Nah. Yeah, so, oh, no, wait, I do. I believe a torch, I think the maggots that are on us from this creature are the ones doing it. Okay. I'll take an Estus. There it is. Yes, that's how we defeat it. Okay. That's the reason that I bought a torch way at the beginning of the game. That item we just grabbed, it was another, Saint Tree Bellvine. It's another, like, catalyst. Not anything I'm particularly too interested in, because we are a, quality build, not a, oh shit, a lizard. We are a quality build, not magic or faith or anything like that, so. Come on. Ah shit, I'm one-handing. No? No? Okay, that was close. Twinkling Titanite. I gotta remember to two-hand another one. Let's see. Alright, let's fight this thing. Oh, we aren't doing shit to it. I think it's because we were hitting it in the back. see if I can get an angle on that. Okay. Well, that went a lot easier than I thought it would. We have some things over here, too, it looks like. If I've ever seen a bullshit wall, it would be something over here. I guess not. I knew I heard something disgusting. Yeah, so there's bleeding and blood loss. You get blood loss from the maggots here. So, get the torch on. It gets rid of it. Poison bite ring. That. See if we can increase his poison resistance. Yeah. Anything with bite in the name. Got another soul. I think that's really it for that area. Yeah, because we came from that way. Is there anything up there? We were chasing the lizard. I feel like we didn't really explore this all the way. Yeah, see, there's an item up here. Where's this drop us down into? I can't really see. I think it was just a stairway that we came from to get in here once we dropped down that ladder. Let's go this way. We have an item up here. Another titan. We are rolling in titanite shards. I really don't feel like we need them much. Unless we want to like use different weapons. I think the next time that I go to, is that another? Is that the dead lizard? Yeah, that's a dead one. Okay, I think I'm backtracking. So we come up here, grab the item. If I end up getting lost, I'll just cut to it now. Alright, well, I didn't even get lost. This leads back to, the stairway. Because you remember, we still have a couple of things to explore up top here. Okay, so this is where we fought Mr. Dual Swords. Explored that, so the only real way to go is up here. Is there anything over here? Yes, there is. Rust and coin, those can always come in handy if we need something. As you can see, there's a big ass door, but of course, it does not open from this side. So, get a red bug pellet. I think that. Going to the wrong thing. Inventory. I think that will increase our. No, that's fire. But fire damage absorption. Oh, I can hear footsteps behind us. Oh. I don't know if you saw that little smoke cloud, but he's throwing his anti-healing stuff that we are under the effect of. Oh no, he's gonna explode. Alright, so fuck that guy. I feel bad, and he wasn't really hurting anyone. This guy will. So he dies. Really quick, I want to point out, see if I can see them. You see that thrall up there? There are thralls hanging all over this area. Yeah, this is rough. Okay. Not that it, oh, yep, he did. Good. We have a ton of arrows over here. Oh, hell. Oh, I apologize for that Steam notification. We have another one of these. Where are these arrows coming from? Oh, he's that dude's chasing me. Okay, that's cute. Alright, so I hear more pitter-patter. Did he not die? We might have to mess with that one other little thrall? I don't know what they're called, the thieves? We're gonna switch to the dark sword, because the area up ahead's gonna get hairy. It's nice to be able to one-shot stuff. Okay, so we don't one-shot shield guys, that's good to know. Heavy bolt. Don't think I don't see your feet. Oh shit, is there two? There's two. Alright, I'll swing. I should have blocked. I think I used seven, the butcher knife. I only saw one, damn. Alright, so we see a fatty on the side. Okay, this looks bad. Do I have... I do. See if I can get the aggro. They look like they're just praying. If I hit him in the face, will he come... Oh, he just dies. Okay. What about you? Damn, he dies too? Alright, well... Ah, shit. Nope. We are not about to get hugged. I wonder what she's protecting. Ah! So do you remember the little... At that fight over... On the ledge with the guy in the window shooting at us? There were enemies that were throwing, like, dust at us? That prevented healing. That's effectively what this is. The Undead Hunter Charm. People use it in PvP to, make it so people can't chug Estus. It's actually kind of funny if you're not expecting it. Because you can... What a lot of people will do is, at least in, like, respectful PvP, I guess, they will throw... They won't use Estus. Damn. Oh, hell. Alright, well, I think we one-shot. Worst case scenario, we can, Okay, so we traded with that guy. Worst case scenario, we can use the little of those kukri knives. I didn't realize exactly how strong they were. Really? Another one? Oh, shit. Alright, that was close. Oh, there's five thrall just hanging out? People won't chug it. Sorry, I got off topic. People won't chug Estus in PvP fights. Like, they won't use it if they're having, like, What's the point of this? I guess you could, Oh, I see. You could drop down and get the item from there. But in PvP, people won't use Estus normally, unless they are, getting invaded. If they're getting summoned, they usually won't. Just kind of like a gentleman's rule, or an unwritten rule. I knew I heard it. Alright, so... Yeah, this is... definitely good we got this dark sword. Highly recommend it if anybody's wanting a bit easier of a time. The R1 spam is really good. I wonder what that sizzling sound just was. So it doesn't look like there's any items over here. Oh, we have two fire people up here. Make sure no one's gonna shoot us from behind. Oh, it wouldn't even matter, we wouldn't be able to kill him anyway. Okay, we have another group of people praying. Usually there's a back waits for a good reason. Is this bullshit? Oh. I heard something making, like, moaning noises. Now we can see what it is. Can we take out, like, two at once? I feel bad. They're just praying. But I want to see what this item is. An ember. Oh! That's really it in this little area. We have doors here. So, we can open these. Oh, we have more of these. You know what? Fuck that. It's not even worth the time to kill. Dual charm? Oh! Okay. I guess that's like poison? Okay, so we have some priests or whatever. Which, this brings me to a good, I guess, little story or discussion. The reason that this area is weird to me is because there's a whole bunch of, like, the whole, I mentioned in the beginning, this kind of pseudo-religious... Oh, we have a lift. I think this leads us up to a shortcut, or maybe down to one. There's a lot of, like, weird pseudo-religion style stuff. You have, like, all these lit candles, you have all of these dudes in robes launching, like, fire magic at you. Is there anything over here? This looks like a lie. Anyways, back to my little story. I don't know if any of you guys have ever watched the TV series Dexter. There's a season where basically the show is there's a guy, he's a serial killer that kills other serial killers. You know what? We don't need to rest at it. I don't feel like being two Estes Downs too bad. But in this series, he kills other people that basically kills bad guys. And in one of the seasons, there's one person who's killing for the name of their god, and I remember I was trying to get my mother to watch Dexter. And she loved the series up until that one part where everything got super religious. So I guess that's where I get it from. But as you can see, we have a fucking giant. So we're gonna run into here. We're gonna ask this up really quick. How you get past this dude is you run and roll past his attacks. This is bad. Okay, let's see if we can grab all these items without dying. Lloyd's sword ring. Exploding bolt. Alright, let's keep running, keep running, keep running. No, I almost made it. There's another area later in the game that's pretty creepy to me too. But we'll save that for later. Alright, so... I don't think that we want to fall down. There's another thrall up here. I need to buy more of these cookery things. I'm gonna save them for whenever I really need them. Oh, what the hell? Oh, there's another one. Come on. Where's your little friend? Did he even see us? Let's see if we can be quick. Really? I could have sworn that thing would have fell on us. Come on. I want to kill this thing so it's not trying to be all sneaky. There's nothing behind. Oh shit. Alright. No! I don't know how I did not take any damage on that. We should have gotten hurt. So what was this chick protecting? An ember. Getting a good little amount of embers. Okay. This was the area where, the dude with the bow was when we were running away from the giant. See? Yeah, right there. Okay, so let's try to descend. There we go. Is there a pathway over here? I guess not. Just some broken candles. Oh, we can go down here. This probably leads to that area that we were. Yeah. This looks fishy. It is. No, we got grabbed. Oh, don't kill us. Come on, we have full health. We don't need to die here. Okay. Almost got him without taking any damage. Deep Braille Divine Tome. We can give that to the blind lady. She can't read tomes that aren't, you know, Braille. I knew something was gonna hurt us. Alright, let's go, dude. Ah, oh, shit, he has magic. Oh, he's a great shield user. Oh, where he slams, stuff explodes. Come on. I don't think you can kick a great shield, so I thought about it, but... That took away all of our stamina when he hit us with that. Can we... Nope, we cannot backstab, but we do a lot of damage if we can hit him. Man, I keep failing the dodge on that shield. Oh, okay. Alright, let's get out of here before we die. God damn. No, why is he swinging so slow? Alright, well, I think that was a bit harder than it needed to be. Is he gonna drop us anything? Nope. Okay, so the path split here. Let's take this left one first. Actually, that's a lie. Let's take the right one. Aw, shit. We're getting invaded. Let's save this room for a little bit. I know it's in that room and it's scary. Okay, do we have any more save to fight? Ah, shit. Alright, I'm gonna try to dodge his ass. Oh shit, we have a slug. See, that's a parry stance if I've ever seen one. Or a guard break stance. Come here, you little shit. Alright, so we got his gear. We got the... Let's see if I can find it. The barbed straight sword. I know he dropped it. Am I blind? The hell is it? Well, let's look at the shield he dropped. He dropped the spiked shield. And I know he dropped a sword. There it is. Wow, went right over it. It has, like, built-in bleed. Later on, we can get his armor, which also has built-in bleed. And I don't think it's really bleed. If you roll into somebody or something with the armor, it will do, like, a little bit of damage. Nothing crazy, but it's still something that's neat. Yeah, that's what we were running from. There's this big-ass spider. I hate spiders. Oh god. Is that even classified as a spider? I don't know if you can hear that noise it's making. Ah, shit. Alright, how much does this do to it? Oh. Oh shit, it gets poisoned too. Alright, well we are going to cheese it. Let's use the new bow we have. Oh damn, it's fast. Oh, it's already dead. Alright, that probably wasn't the most manly way to take it out, but... And it's dead regardless. Aldrich is sapphire? Hmm. Yeah, there's a ring. Okay, recovers FP from critic. Damn. That's not bad. Here's what I'm gonna do. Since we have 44,000 souls, I'm gonna throw on Ring of Sacrifice. That way if we die, we don't lose all of our stuff. Our health's getting decently high, too. So I feel like that's kind of justified taking off that life ring. We were going to take it off eventually. So I guess now is a good time to wean me off of that extra HP. Alright, so... I know I heard something, right? Yes. Oh, shit. So these statues spit out poison. Not good at all. Nope. I'm going to quickly check, because I know there's something we need to do. It's either over here or on the other side. It's on the other side. As you can see, there's the giant over there, and then there's another giant over here. We can go over here. If these thrall can stop trying to sneak attack us. Okay, there's another one of these guys. Shit. So we're going to pull this lever. Oh, please do not kill us. Oh god, GG. That raises that wall. Oh no, 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 no. Don't do that. Heal. Okay, so I think he takes less damage when he's buffed like that. Yeah, see, we just did literally... Okay, we go for the kill. Alright, come here, little thrall. So we can make our way... in here, yeah, this is the new area. Oh, is this another shortcut? Okay, if you remember, we defeated that one, this is that one weird alleyway that we found, yeah. Is there anything down here? Yes, a door. We are getting So we have this fully unlocked. I am going to, rest. I probably shouldn't have, because that one big dude with the shield is going to spawn again. We have a lift here. Where does this take us? It takes us up. Okay. So we're going to take a break from... that area up top, I think. What's this do? That's a lie. We are going to take a break. I say up top, I meant down here. We're going to go back down and finish this, the catacombs. There's an area above that, this like giant church pit thing that we were in that we can explore, but I thought that was a live to do so. Maybe it was. If it is, we'll be back there, but yeah, I hear... the big dude. Walk in shit. Nope. Man, he's faster than me. It's no fair. I wonder if it'll run to that poison. Yeah? Only does like 6 damage, but... Alright, let's fight you one more time. Shit. Good thing it was a slow one. I thought he was about to hit me with a shield. Come on, do it. I know you want to. Ah, he did. Shit! Ah, we just took right to the face. Alright. We're gonna go this way. See, there's a giant over there. There's one more lever we need to pull. It is over here. That's gonna pull up another wall. We have a bunch of items over here, but we have a giant. We have a ton of slugs in the water. You can run past this giant if you need to. The way you fight him is you just get behind him and smack the hell out of the ankles. You will be fat rolling in this area though, so that's another good thing to kind of note. Hoping with this dark sword we can do a lot of damage to his ankles quickly, because this can take a little bit of time. I try to get out of the way. Okay, he's gone. I think. Yeah. So we're gonna get some dung pie. In what I'm assuming is the full Drang set? Oh, Pale Tongue, that's another Covenant item. Don't poke me, I am friend. Drang Shoes. There's another item just kind of hiding over here. Drang Hammers. God, I hate fat rolling. Anything that slows down gameplay, I'm a huge fan of not having. Alright, so we have some badness over here. So you see these guys sleeping on the pews? They are really not an issue. Just do not break their pews or hit them. There's an item over here. Alright, I'd prefer to take the big dude out with these guys not in the way. Yeah, he heard me swing. Oh, that's no bueno. If I could roll, that'd be awesome. Oh god, he's gonna break everything. Don't. No. I will fight you over here. That's a lie. I'll fight him with these two gone. Alright, let's go. How much stamina do you have? Damn, he's throwing kicks and everything. Oh, you tried to shank me in the kidney. Alright. There's an area right there. We're gonna hold off on going to. I swear. Yes, I remember faintly an invisible wall in this area. I don't think it had anything crazy important. If it does, I'll be going back to it. Aha. Let's open up the door. Okay, this was that giant door after the graveyard. So that opened up a gigantic shortcut. Was that the only reason for that lift? Oh, look! It's our buddy Sigurd. We have an item over here. Are those consumables? Yes. Temporarily disables special effects in vicinity. Okay. Alright, let's talk to him.
Well, you look reasonably sane. I am a knight of Katarina. I've managed to track down this cathedral store of...
Apologies for the controller.
It's right over there, across that narrow part. Treasure. Always so close, yet so far. I'm in quite a pickle, indeed.
There we go. Okay, so listening to him, we need to go across this way.
Shame on you, you greedy guts. Thought you could outwit an onion. Well, say hello to the nice giant. He adores visitors.
Well, we got holy shit. We got swindled by a dude that stole Sigurd's armor. Luckily, I don't think that guy understands how pathetic giants are. Watch me say how pathetic they are, and then I'm gonna get killed. One more. There we go. Alright, so with that giant done, we need to... Am I on the right side? I'm not. We need to re-raise those platforms and go back up there. The other one was to our left up here. Okay, so he gave us a large titanite shard. That's good. This is going to be a bit of a long episode. I don't like ending off episodes and then having to do a boss fight at the beginning of the next one. Which doesn't seem... I don't know, like the episode with when I left off before the Abyss Watchers. We ended up doing the Abyss Watchers, and then the, oh god, fat rolling. And then the next area had... Like, the next area had a whole bunch of, I don't even know what I'm trying to say. The whole area was really easy. It was really... We got through it pretty quickly. So we ended up having, like, two boss fights in one episode. When in reality, I probably could have just squeezed that boss fight in and made the episode a little bit longer. So... Let's go back over here. Let's not jump down this hole. Let's see if we can confront what's his tits. The mashed potato face guy that stole Sigurd's stuff. Wait, I didn't grab the... Did I do the other lift? I did not, so I will jump down and do that in a second. Aw, damn. Alright. I completely spaced out doing that, so I'll meet you guys back here whenever I, go down and pull that other lever. Okay, so, it turns out that everything is done in that area currently, that needs to be done. We cannot raise that platform up right now. We do need to come over here.
Anyone there?
Yeah.
I know that voice.
It's us.
Just how long has it been?
It's me, Siegfried of Katarina. I'm loath to admit it, but I've been had. Someone's swiped my armor.
Gee.
Did you happen to see it anywhere?
Oh, haven't seen it, I guess.
Not to worry. Great planning begets great fortune. An old tenant of the Knights of Katarina.
Ah, damn, I skipped some dialogue. Where we need to go is actually up that lift. The one that took us up to the tower with the sniper on it. I don't exactly remember where it was. No, it was at this door over here. Oh god, that we almost ran right off of it. So let's kill the sniper. We go out this way. Sorry, actually I had to pull up pull up my notes. Like I said, don't like this area, super confusing. Bring? What's that do? Oh, there's more spells, which another thing we don't need to worry about. Okay, so we can come up here. Oh, we have a ton of axemen. If I could lock on, that'd be absolutely fantastic. We have Thrall behind us too. I just saw one climb. No. Alright. I feel like we recovered from almost disaster. Being up here on the scaffolding is not something that's nice. So we can go in there, but let's explore up here first. Okay, so we get another pale tongue. Nope, not bullshit. Alright, so we have to go. Where is it? Right in here. Now this area is super dangerous. You'll see why in a second. As you can see, there's a dude with a big ass sword over here. I don't feel like rolling like anywhere other than straight. I doubt we can kick him, like, off. Alright. So we get a blessed gem. But he's not the real threat. I don't know if you can see, there are two more of these giant knights up here. That is the scary part. So let's be as careful as we can. Here's my plan. You see that little platform? Over down right there where my dude's head is looking at. We're gonna try to get to over to there. Run past him. And we can drop down. Oh hell. You see our buddy, did he fall down with us? Oh, damn, he fell all the way down. I just heard him die. I heard him take damage. Alright, so let's kill this weird slug dude. As you can see, here's the dude, little tomato face, that stole Sigurd's armor.
Yes, hello. I don't believe we've met.
Nah, we met. You're the scumbag.
Unbreakable patches. You seem to be unkindled.
You'd be right. You know who I am.
Oh, yes, of course. It's coming back to me now. Oh, I'm so sorry. That was my hand, as you know. But the deed, well, that was the armor's doing.
How so?
Regrettable, truly. But behold, I'm stripped clean of that unruly attire. Look at you. Not a scratch. All's well,
well we're on fire.
Right?
I think that's a little bit worse than the scratch.
Yes, we'll be fine. I can tell. It's that rotten curse. It is. The untidy mess.
So here's the prostration emote. Oh, and a rusted coin. So if we keep talking to him, he'll have a bunch of items for us to buy. One of which being Sigurd's armor. No problem. I wish I could kill him. Probably can. But he'll actually show up at the Firelink Shrine. So. If we pull this, that'll take us back over there. And then see, it'll raise it up. With that being done, there is not much left for us to do besides fight the boss. Actually, I lied. I just checked in my guide again. There's, yeah, see, there's a stairway up here. I can't believe I almost forgot this. If we come up here, we will have more maggots. I wouldn't even call these maggots, they're like big-ass slugs. Luckily, they're pretty, like, weak. Oh, they're dropping a lot of undead hunter charms. We have another one, but he's friendly. For some reason, he doesn't want to fight us, so we won't be douche-weeds and kill him. But if we open up these doors, we have one of the, I'd probably say for single player, the most useful, covenant. This covenant is Rosaria's Fingers. Let's grab this item. We'll light that bonfire in a second. See, this was, Longfinger Kirk, or Lordfinger, whatever his name is. That was his armor. If we talk to her, we can ask to join the covenant. I'm not going to accept this, because this can potentially ruin some things in the future. But if you... This faction, if you come to this lady, it will let you essentially redistribute all of your stats. You can do this 5 times per, like, I guess, new game. So it's pretty useful if you're, let's say you're playing... I know the first time I played through the game, I was just distributing stats to whatever, like whatever weapon scaled right and all that stuff. Let's try to run away from all this. We don't really need to fight it. And I remember I used her a few times, because I ended up doing a, like tried to do a full strength build. I didn't really like how that was. I ended up trying to do a full dexterity build, trying to use like the Uchi Katana, weapons like that. And it wasn't really too fun. I ended up sticking with that full dex build though, just because it was. I was used to the. I used a sword called the Pontiff Curved Sword, which you can buy from a. From. The thief, Greerat. You can buy from him once he goes and pillages to. The Undead Settlement. But since we can't seem to get his ass to leave, which I think is because of that Sigurd issue right there. I think. I could be completely wrong. But I think that since we didn't have this little Sigurd issue, he won't go. But this is the next boss fight, the Deacons of the Deep. Now, there's a ton of them. You're going to be thinking, oh shit. Do not really be scared. This boss fight is not that difficult. I'm saying that now, I'm going to die to it, guaranteed. Essentially, there's going to be a flame that chases... I'm actually going to run over here. I gotta be quick. I'm gonna switch to the butcher knife. Because this thing has range. And this can let us just, like, cleave through. Oh, we're fat rolling. Do we have, I guess that torch is weighing us down. As you can see, if you knock down the fat ones, they kind of roll into everybody. Like every boss fight in Dark Souls, there is a second stage to this one. As you can see, we are just cleaving through a ton of them. Which, the second stage of this can be a little bit, I wouldn't say worrisome. I will show you one thing that you can do. I gotta be quick with this one as well. Alright, let's heal up. You can throw one of these alluring skulls on the ground. And it will lead all of them to it. They will not attack you. Even though this is a boss fight, these enemies aren't technically considered bosses. As you can see now, the main one spawns. So we can throw down another alluring skull. He has some... a couple of blue bastards. We'll throw down another one. Try to weed our way through here. I'll just lob another skull. If I can get out of this shitty camera angle, Jesus. Okay, this is bad. We need to not let him build up whatever he was just building up. I just see our curse is building up and he's recovering health. So we need to effectively kill him now. Okay. That's the scary part of this. As you can see, we got the small doll that we need to get into Irithyll of the Boreal Valley. Once your curse builds up, I know we haven't died to it yet, but once that gets completely full, we will die. Plain and simple, you just die. So, here's what we're going to do. We're going to travel to a cleansing chapel bonfire, and we're going to give Sigurd his armor back in the well. Then we're going to go to the shrine and see what we can do there. I feel like there was a, what would it be called? An undead bone shard in this area that I haven't grabbed, but I could be wrong. I know I felt that during my first playthrough as well. It seemed weird that we were getting Estus shards more than undead ones, but we should be fine. So we'll give him his armor.
Oh, my armor. My deepest gratitude. I'm Siegfried of Katarina, salute you. With my trusty suit of armor, I'll be...
I don't know why armor would... like, you figured it'd be easier to get out of a well without it. Because you'd weigh less. So... we're going to go back to this bonfire. We're going to go back to the shrine, upgrade our Estus uses, level up a little bit, and then we'll end the episode there. This is going to be a very long episode. So, I'm going to quickly check to see if Greerat has even left. Doesn't look like it. Yeah, yeah, I don't know why he won't leave. I'm pretty sure it has something to do with me, what's it called? Doing this out of order. So let's talk to Andre. Can I reinforce my dark sword at all? No, I need two chunks to get it to level 7. What about the butcher knife? Where would that be at? I can do the butcher's knife. We can do that twice.
Pretty, be careful.
I will be careful. Let's talk to Cornix. I believe. Oh, I thought I'd talk to you. He gives you the pyromancy flame, so you can use fire. So we're gonna give him. Oh wow, we have a lot of these.
Yes.
All right, we're just gonna give him all of them and burn through it.
The primal.
But I regret to say.
Okay, so he can't accept this one.
Pyromancies are for witches and must be learned from the mistress. But thank you. If only I were a woman.
So he cannot use that tome.
I'm afraid I can't.
And he cannot use this one either. So,
what is it?
Shocker, there's going to be an NPC that we can get later that can use those tomes.
Oh, champion, if I was not meant to be a fike, the gods are empty.
Yes, that's neat. So we'll give her this braille tome.
Champion, these are dark tales of Corony. The little creep. Have a pleasant journey.
So we essentially gave her a dark cursed tome or whatever. If we do, as you can see, we have Henri and Horace.
Oh, we spoke before. I'm well pleased.
Yes.
The little dog, Aldrin, a pilgrim and so.
That essentially tells you, this guy never speaks, tells you about everything that you need to do to get past Farron Keep and the story of the silver doll that we just got from the cathedral. That lets us get into Yrthil. If we run up here, we will see. Not Patches. Patches should be up here. So let's come down here. Let's talk to the firekeeper. Actually, no, we have a ton of soul consumables to use. Actually, we need to go, talk to Ludoliv and see if we can get our see what weapon we can get. Okay, so we can either get the cleric's candlestick or deep soul, which is a sorcery. We can't even really effectively use this candlestick, so we aren't going to get any of those. So we're going to consume the soul, and I'm curious to see how much it gives us. Okay, 20,000. That's more like it.
Welcome, speak very well, then take none.
Okay, so we have a good amount of souls to work with here. We are 5 up, so we'll do this. Let's level up our health, and we'll do our endurance in the next one. So, confirm.
Farewell, Ashen.
Wait, can we give her the firekeeper? So I didn't realize that.
Ashen, much light, then let it find its own place.
Within her bosom.
She'll understand. We are both firekeepers, after all.
Okay.
Forgive me, sister. May the flames guide thy way.
So, farewell. I don't know if you remember Yol of Londor. But he has died, and someone else is in her place. You remember how we had to essentially unleash our true power or whatever 5 times? We do it 5 times because that's A, the max, and B, it continues the quest line. So let's talk to her.
Oh, prithee. Art thou good Yol's master?
Yeah.
I am Uria of Londor, a close friend of his. Thanks to thee, Yol's soul is redeemed. Allow me to express my gratitude in his stead.
So we get a dignified bow emote.
That a lord art thou not, bearer of the dark sigil, and our lord of hollows. For the time thou remainst our lord, we of Londor shall serve thee.
Oh shit. So we can buy stuff from her. We can buy this, the untrue dark ring, and the untrue white ring. Now, we are effectively hollow. Which, if you remember, yeah, see, so we have all of these things we can give her. This dark hand. This is, I'm almost certain what the Dark Wraith uses. I could be wrong. But these rings are mostly for invasions. Well, I guess this is the only ring for invasion. When you invade other people, let's say you can invade a specific covenant, and you, a lot of times you'll appear yellow, blue, red. This will make you disappear white, so you look like a normal summon. You can really get pretty mean with it. This ring is just going to make us not look like an absolute fucking zombie.
May the dark sigil guide thee.
So apparently we are the lord of whatever. Lord of Londor, and they will serve us, so.
Our lord and liege. Knowest thou of a maid named Anri?
Yeah.
She is hollow. And will join thee in wedlock.
Well.
A fellow of mine guides her at this moment. When the time is ripe, thou mayst make thy salutations. For what lord taketh no spouse? Till we meet again.
Yeah, till we meet again. Hmm. So apparently, Henri's little traveling companion is hollow.
Aldrich's honest home is a pilgrim told me that, and so become.
Maybe they're gonna give us something new. Anyways, that's gonna be it for this episode. It was a long one. If you stuck around to the end, thank you. As always, drop a like, leave a comment, you know, if you enjoyed the series. Subscribe if you want to see more from the series. And any criticism is appreciated. Anything that might help me do it better, anything you might want to see, always accepted. So, I'll see you guys in the next episode. See ya.